Do tannins really help age a wine? Welcome to Wine Not. What is it that ages a wine the longest? Tannins, alcohol, acidity, or sugar? Alcohol is definitely a preservative, which is why in a science laboratory we see lizards and other reptiles preserve in an alcohol solution. But in order to keep the specimen in a suspended state, the alcohol level has really got to be quite high indeed. Most wines are between 10 and 15 degrees alcohol, which, while it preserves the wine to a certain extent, is not really that high. Tannins, which come from the fruit and the plant, these holistic tannins help age and evolve a wine. They are part of the plant. Wood tannins that come from oak barrels, on the other hand, these are extraneous tannins. And when there's too much of it, they get in the way of the fruit from expressing itself. And again, when there's too much of it, unfortunately, after 10, 20 or more years, what you're really left with is a rather expensive wood juice. When a wine is over-oaked and the fruit has disappeared, what you're really left with, these so-called wines, they taste more like furniture. That which age a wine the longest are acidity and sugar, the natural sweetness of a wine. Which is why the most long-lived, greatest white wines of the world are an oak Riesling, particularly from the Mosel, Rheingau and other parts of Germany, Chenin Blanc from the Loire Valley. Both these wines, whether dry, medium dry or intensely ripe, rich and sweet, and back to dry wines, the an oak Semillon of the Hunter Valley. In the case of Tokaj and Sauternes, like Riesling, Chenin Blanc and dry Semillon from the Hunter Valley, all these wines are practically indestructible. As for a red sweet wine, vintage port of the Douro, it is not the extra fortification of alcohol that keeps them going for so long, but rather the rich, intense ripeness kept and retained when the fermentation is halted that makes these wines practically immortal.